Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at using numbered headings in Pages. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So recently, I've seen a lot of people requesting the ability to have numbered headings in Pages. This is where you have a heading for a section, say section 1, and then maybe a subsection 1.1, and then the next section is section 2, and they all have numbers in the headings and they'll automatically adjust. If you add a new section between 2 and 3, then it pushes all the sections after it up by a number, so 4, 5, 6, etc. So to accomplish this, what we're going to do is use numbered bullet lists, but we're going to only use them in the headings. And then use a few other settings to get it working even though the text in between the headings is not part of the list. First I'm going to show you starting with a blank document and then we'll go and look at an existing document and how to convert it to this system. So here I am in a blank Pages document. And let's start off with a heading. I'm just going to use the word heading for all the headings here. Obviously each one would have a different name in your document. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a special style for this. I'm going to make it bold and increase the size a bit. And I'm going to go in and add a new style and I'm going to call this numbered heading. And now whenever I want to use this style I can easily access it. Now I want to add the number and I'm going to do that using bullets and lists down here below. So I'm going to click this to reveal the bullets and list settings and I'm not going to use one of the preset styles but instead I'm going to create my own. So I'm going to go to this menu here, choose numbers. Then I'm going to scroll down more because there's more options now. And I'm going to make sure I've selected the standard numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm going to choose tiered numbers. And I'll leave continue from previous on. Now I want to create a style for this. Bullets and list styles are separate from the regular styles here. So you can see I can click here and I can hit the plus button. And I'm going to just call this heading. This is my own style. This is a very important step because if you try to use one of the existing styles or you don't use styles at all, it's going to make things very difficult. Now I'm going to hit return and I'm going to add another heading and add a few more. Now if I want to add a subsection here, I can hit return after this. It'll insert a new one and then I can hit the tab key to indent in or use this button here. When I do, notice the number goes away at this level. The second level there's no number. Let's type heading there. But I'm going to go back here to the bullets and list settings. I'm going to change this to numbers. Make sure I've got tiered numbers turned on and continue from previous. And I can see now it says 1.1 which is great. But notice here where it says heading asterisk we've changed something about the heading style. So I want to update it. So I'll click the update button here. Now let's create another subsection one level deeper. I'll hit return there. It goes to 1.2. I'll tab in and it goes to the next level. Let's do the same thing there. So I'll change it to numbers. I'll check everything here and then I'll update heading. Now I can use these freely. So I can go to a new level here. I'll shift tab or use this left button to go back up like that. I can add subheadings here under 3, tab in. Have another section in here. Tab back out. And you can see how I could do it. Now let's further modify this. Instead of having all these indents, let's have everything flush to the left. After all, we're going to have text in between these that's going to be flush left. So it makes sense to have the headings there as well. So I want to click here, one of the ones that's indented by one level. And I'm going to look here under indent and I've got a 0.5 inch indent. So I'm going to switch that to 0. Then I'm going to go in here and update again and you see everything at that level moves over to 0. I'll click one of these which is two levels in and I'll also change that from a 1 inch indent to 0 and update. So now everything's there flush with the left. I can also work with the space after the number. You can see here there's a nice space but here there's not. If I look here at this level, I can see here that the title starts at 0.25 inches. If I click here, you can see it also starts at 0.25 inches, but the 1.1 dot is more than that. So it makes more sense to have something like 0.4. Now I need to do the update again. And let's go to this level here and I'll change this to 0.6 and I'll update again. So now I've got nice spacing in between these. It doesn't work that great once you have more digits. Once I go and have 10.11.12, then it's really going to push things out. So this isn't ideal, but it's the best we can do. Now these are great headings, but I want to actually have text in here. So I'm going to put the cursor right after this heading and I'm going to hit return and it's going to add a new section. I don't want a new section. So I'm going to go here to bullets and lists and set list style to none. So now you could see that I've got regular text there. Let me insert something. I'll paste some text in. Let's change that style to body text. So there we go. And I can do the same thing, say, with this section here. Instead of changing to bullets and lists none, I could also just, as soon as I hit return, hit delete. And it automatically sets the type of list to none. So I'll paste some text in. I'll set its style to body. And all this setting of styles here, you can make that easier. If you click in here, you could see for numbered heading, if I click here, I can set a shortcut, one of the F keys. Same thing for body. I can set a shortcut for that. I can also do the same thing here for bullets and lists. Under here, you can see I could set a shortcut for that and just have a real easy way to set these. Now notice that even though I've inserted text in between these, the numbering still picks up. You still get 1.1, 1.1.1, and all of that. And that's because, you see, if I select in here, I have continue from previous set to on. So if for some reason one of these doesn't pick up the numbering from the previous heading, then just go and check to make sure continue from previous is set on for that line. If it's turned off for any of these, it will simply break this and start over again at one. Now I can also do various things to make it look nicer. For instance, instead of having numbered heading style for everything, I could have numbered heading 1, numbered heading 2, numbered heading 3, and make it, say, a little smaller for each one of these. I could also change the indenting a little bit, maybe not go back to the extreme that it originally was, but say if I want the first level here to be indented slightly, so maybe 0.2, so it's indented a little bit, then I can update and you can see all those are in a little bit. And then the third level there, I could have that go in 0.5 and then update and they will all update. So you can still do that. And then you could do the same thing here for the body text. So body could be indented 0 to match this, but then body 2, you can create that and say have it under layout, indents, and have the left match here, both the first line and the rest. So you can see how it's underneath like that. Then I could go back here and create a new body 2 that I can then use again every time. You're going to have to really pay attention to everything you type to setting of styles. But once it's all set up, it's not that hard to do and you can make changes that then go through the entire document. Plus, by using this, I can insert a new section anywhere I want and the numbering will be pushed down. So here I have between 2 and 3, I can hit return, insert a new section 3, and you can see the old section 3 is now 4 and everything else is pushed down and renumbered. But what if you already have a document and you have these headings in there and you want to implement this afterwards? You're going to use the same tools, but implementing it's going to be a little different. So let's go to this first heading here. I've already created a numbered heading style and all of these are using that. So now it's just a matter of getting the numbered bullets in there. So I'll put my cursor in the first one and I'll go to bullets and lists. I'll choose numbers and then I'll set it to tiered numbers and continue from previous. Now I'll go and create a style for that. So I'll click here and I'll hit the plus button and then I'll call this heading. And now that one's set. So now I can go down to here and you'd think I'd be able to click here and then choose heading and it would work. But in fact, it thinks it's the beginning of a new list. So even though I've applied the style, I still have to go and use continue from previous. And now you can see it picks up. And I could do the same thing here. So I'll do heading and then continue from previous and it picks up there. But now what if this is 1.1, not 2? So I'll go in here and I'll click this button or hit tab and you can see it doesn't know that it should be numbered. So I have to go in again and say numbers, make sure tiered is checked, make sure continue from previous is on, And now that that's set, I need to update the style. And I only need to do that the first time I do a second level here. So let's go and do a third level here. I'll do Tab In. You can see it thinks it's 1.2. So far so good. Tab In again. Doesn't have the numbering there at that level. So I'll go and choose Numbers. And then I will update. Now I can also have this go flush left. So let's go back at here at this level. And I will change the indent to 0. And since I'm here, I'll change the text indent to 0.4. So it moves a little bit away from that. And then I will update. And that takes care of it for that level. And then here, I'll go and I'll update stuff there as well. I'll set this to 0. I'll set this to 0.6. And now I need to update here as well. So now for this one, I need to go and assign heading. So I'll set it here. And then I need to check continue from previous, which is always going to be a pain. You're always going to have to do that manually. Now if I tab in, you could see it correctly goes to 1.2. Tab in again, you could see it correctly goes to 1.1.2. If you need another level, you just need to repeat the steps from before. I can shift tab to go back like that. Now that sounds like a lot of work for every heading, but you could use copy and paste to kind of do it quickly. So here I don't have the heading set for the next one. Instead I'm going to select this line, copy, go down here and paste. And the cool thing is when you copy and paste, it not only remembers the style, so you can see here it's style is heading, but it remembers the continue from previous. So I can continue now to paste new headings, then just change the text. And even if I select in there and go and tab in, it will do the numbering correctly. So that's how you do it. It's not perfect. You're not using the numbered bullet list for what they were intended for. You're kind of taking that functionality, combining it with headings, and using the continue from previous to kind of get this functionality. So it's not perfect. It's a little frustrating to work with. You kind of have to get the hang of it. And then even once you get the hang of it, it's kind of frustrating to change things here and there. But for long documents, it's definitely better than typing the number manually and then having to deal with changing all the numbers if you insert a section. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.